Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Panther Productions' exclusive video interview on the rare and exotic Brazilian martial art of Capoeira. And representing this exotic art is Mr. Nilson Reyes and Mr. Amen Santos, who are masters in Capoeira. Now, they're living in the United States at this time, and they're traveling around giving seminars and educating people as to exactly what Capoeira is. So welcome, gentlemen.
Thanks. It's a pleasure being here.
Thank you. Let's start at the beginning. Tell me about the history of Capoeira. When did it evolve? First of all, what does the name exactly mean?
Capoeira. Is that the name of Capoeira? It used to be when the slave run away from their own, go up to the jungle and try to make his own thing. It used to be Capoeira. They used to call the slave Capoeira.
And a runaway slave was called Capoeira?
They used to call Capoeira.
I see.
And also, a lot of times in Brazil, when people used to do anything bad in the street, too, used to say, oh, he's a capoeirista. You know, that's Capoeira.
He's like a runaway, a rebel.
Runaway, a rebel. People actually, they give a really bad reputation for the name, because every time when a black person do anything wrong in the street or try to rob somebody or use any kind of fight, they always say Capoeira, Capoeira, get away from this Capoeira, you know.
Oh, coming from a long history, the name?
Yeah.
And how did it evolve, Amen? I mean, is it true it evolved on the boats?
It still have a lot of problems because nobody can describe how did it evolve Capoeira in Brazil. Some people say they bring Capoeira from Angola, and some people say they developed Capoeira in Brazil, in Bahia. Uh-huh. It's a city in Brazil. And the way the last book I read, they say the Capoeira is made in Brazil from Angolan. People from Africa did the Capoeira in Brazil.
Uh-huh.
And that's how they developed Capoeira, did they develop Capoeira in Brazil.
Yeah, basically it is. When the slave was from Angola, Africa, mm-hmm. But basically Capoeira started in Brazil, mm-hmm. with Angola slave, right? When the Portuguese brought the slave from Africa, Angola, to Brazil, and they fight for the freedom, they use a lot of Capoeira. So basically Capoeira born in Brazil, but it is a background, Africa background, with like a lot of things too.
Maybe the fighting for freedom developed the martial arts more in Brazil.
Right.
But they had the background, they had the basis of it in Africa? Is that it?
Nobody really know.
Nobody can prove if they mean Africa. But the history say they mean Brazil because he have a lot of, a lot of peoples, and because how can Africa make Capoeira in Angola? Because they bring the African first to Bahia to work in the lands.
Uh-huh.
So that's how the slaves develop Capoeira, because the old slave tried to get freedom, so that's why he did Capoeira, to have some
self-defense.
Self-defense.
Because the slaves couldn't have weapons, right?
Right.
So they had to develop their fighting. Is Capoeira a Portuguese or African name?
Portuguese name. Capoeira is a Portuguese name.
Ah, I see. Now, this self-defense system, why is it so unique in the going into the low position and kicking high, and why do they have these type of techniques? Was it the mountain terrains, or was it the...
I think the Capoeira have a lot of different things, like handstand and flips, and
yeah.
We call Aua, Carl Hills is called Aua. Mm-hmm. It's because I think of each ability of a slave or the person to be practice Capoeira. And for the reason we could do it anything, we could not have any kind of martial art or use a weapon. So people use, Capoeira, the people used to practice Capoeira for fight as a self-defense. And when anybody else come to see it, and try to see Capoeira, we always try to hide, somebody come around, so let's do a flip. Let's do a no contact Capoeira.
Oh, I see.
So we started to do flippers and Aú and Jinga. The people say it's a dance. Jinga and a lot of flips and no contact kicks at all.
Oh.
So when the people get away, we start get you know, into and do
into
contact.
The techniques more. So what you're saying is, if the slaves were training and the authorities came, they would disguise it right. as a dance or flipping tumbling. Right.
That's what the, ah. they have the muse.
And that's that. There's another thing too.
Oh, so more like a festival with right. the music, and then the police would think, well,
it's only, you know, they don't
they're only well. Having a party they and play, right. playing. Exactly. But in reality, you're training to the music,
to
right?
To the music and try to. Oh. I think. I mean, that's what I think. I think that's how the music get in, because uh-huh. for the you know, for the try of hide the martial art. Mm-hmm. So we have to put the music in, the drums and right. flips and right. you know, dance, like people say dance. I don't think Jing is dance, but people say the steps are dance. Just, you know, just to survive, just to yeah. hide the fight.
Now, I've heard the music that goes with the training, and they might have just developed it because it's really great to train with. I mean, it mm-hmm. is motivating music. I'm sure if American martial artists hear it, they might want to play it in their training sessions. Because it really, you know, you're training hard, but the music seems to take away the stress of it.
Right. This is to give energy. Basically, yeah. it is. Sometimes when we get in the harder, we call the circle when people fight, we call harder. Sometimes when you get in the harder and you feel like kind of tired and stuff, and see people playing there and fight. I mean, I don't know. Somehow we get some energy from the beating ball or something. Right. We just get a
the beating ball gives you energy somehow. So yeah. It's amazing. When you start to play, you get some energy from the music. Then you start to play, you don't want to stop anymore.
And speaking of the music, let's see some of the instruments that they use for capoeira. Now, what is this called?
It's called berimbau. It's
right.
the main instrument in capoeira. It's necessary to...
Okay. Now, you were telling me earlier that people who study capoeira, they must learn how to play this instrument.
Yeah.
Because when one's training, the other's playing? Just is that play. The way
every
it
time,
is?
Every time we have a capoeira circle, a roda de capoeira, mm-hmm. We need the berimbau, we need the pandeiro, we need the drum, we call uh-huh. atabaque.
Uh-huh.
It's, you know, some people use a conga, it's kind of similar to conga.
Right.
Atabaque and chocalhos, uh-huh. the xícara,
yeah.
and the pandeiro, a gogo bell. There's a lot of, you know, a lot of music instrument.
So now, what is this? This is like a
we call cabasa.
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 Okay. And this is a bamboo pole.
Yeah, bamboo pole.
And you got your string here. This is pretty tight. And well, how would you create a rhythm, a beat?
We have to use the rod.
Okay.
Right here.
Here's a little rod.
Put between your fingers. Hold the stick in this way, and bring to your stomach. And by the tongue, and you move the rock back and forth,
uh-huh.
and take the cabasa out of your stomach.
Oh, and that creates
a different
tone.
Like, you know,
yeah.
this is 1, 2, 3, 4, right, and this.
Oh yeah. Great. You're playing, you start out kind of slow, and the person training starts out a little slow, and then it builds up and up and up,
yeah.
and you go faster to the...
I want to explain that. Like, the berimbau, you have different rhythm you call, like the capoeira Angola or capoeira regional. When you play capoeira Angola, you can play that rhythm, like... That's when you play very low and, you know, yeah. a lot of mandinga you call.
Uh-huh. A lot of low fighting technique.
Yeah, low fighting technique.
Really, uh-huh.
Really and, slick. In regional, you play a little more faster, like São Bento Grande, you go like...
And that's the upward, standing
yeah,
up
that's
moving?
That's when you do a lot of flips and kick.
Tumbling?
High, yeah. Kicks
right. Ah, I see. Okay, great.
And they have a rhythm called yuna.
Uh-huh.
Yuna, when people play yuna, you're not supposed to hit anybody. You know, you have to go on the circuit and show your ability and flips
mm-hmm.
and flexibility and everything. We cannot hit. You have to be...
You have to show your technique.
Yeah, it's a kind of a competition between both and the circle. But you guys don't kick nobody. You
uh-huh.
just flip, you know.
Right.
If you're going to kick, then they got to be open. We call jogo aberto, means open game.
Uh-huh.
Right? So we never hit each other. Go fast or anything, you know.
All, right.
I mean, they never trust the person. He might want to hit you, but you cannot do that. Uh-huh. But always, you know, don't trust anybody in the other, really. So we call Yun. Yun's going like this.
What would be the rhythm if it's a real fight?
We call sombento grande. They say, jogo de dentro, jogo de fora. It means like inside games, outside games.
Uh-huh.
We play, the fight can be in Angola, the fight can be in sombento grande, the fight can be in sombento pequeno, you know, cavalaria, whatever. I mean, you know, and capoeira, actually, you never expect when the person is going to hit you or not, so you have to be prepared all
right.
the time.
Right.
So
yeah,
basically, the rhythm, Yuna, I mean, that's what I know. Yuna, you cannot hit. Yuna
right.
is like an open game. Most of the people play Yuna, they'll be friends and like show off and stuff. Uh-huh. But any other rhythm, you can go there and hit and mm-hmm. fight.
Okay.
You want to say something?
Yeah, but you do have a rhythm when you fight. You want to get in the fight and be very strong.
Right.
You know? So play very fast. It goes from bento grande, but fast.
Yeah.
Go like.
Get you going.
Okay. Yeah, you know, they have a lot of energy from the beating ball. We really feel it
yeah,
when we get there.
Definitely. All right. And that weapon, or that's not a weapon, it's just an instrument, right?
No, this is the weapon too. They put a little machete here.
Little machete?
Yeah, there was a guy, a master, his name is Pastinha.
Uh-huh.
He say that. And through the books and record, he said that he used a beating ball a few times for fight.
For fighting, I see.
But one more time, just to survive, it doesn't mean we have a beating ball and a capoeira as a weapon. No, just to survive. I mean, like, if you're going to be in a fight and you have a pen,
yeah.
and the guys are showing that you're going to use your pen.
Right.
That's
so
a weapon.
Yeah.
It is a weapon.
That's true.
Right? But Pastinha, he used to have a beating ball. He put a little knife called machete, mm-hmm. a really machete on the bottom of the beating ball.
Yeah.
Take the cabas off.
Yeah.
And he just, you know, use it.
Yeah.
Definitely. No special technique or anything. He just used it for defending himself.
Now, capoeira, is it a set style? You know, like taekwondo might have a set pattern of forms and sparring techniques and all that. But is your system set, you have to learn it this way, or is it constantly evolving? You know, do you have certain basics, like, you know, you would learn in Brazil, and if you went to any school in Brazil, like, they would all start at the same?
It's like karate. We uh-huh. have a different style. I'm come from different school. He have a different style.
Oh.
We have, we've been working together for a long time, so that's why, basically, they start to feel like similar right now because, you know, I learned from him, he learned from me.
Right.
So we always have, we be work together. So basically right now, we can say we have the same style.
Uh-huh.
For the reason we be practicing together, you know. But there are a few things that he learned in his school that I never learned in my school.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I did learn it, but a different technique.
Right.
As like in my school, and he might, you know, learn in a different way.
Uh-huh.
But capoeira is like, yeah, it's like karate, you get it? We have a belt. We don't call belt, we call cordão. It's a cord.
A cloth?
Yeah, uh-huh. a cord, you know. And people have, some people use a belt as karate.
Right.
White, yellow, orange, right. green, blue, whatever
right.
it is. And some people use two different colors or even three colors.
Uh-huh.
And I think the original style is when the people take the colors from the flag.
The colors.
The Brazilian flag is green, blue,
and yellow,
yellow mm-hmm. and white.
Uh-huh.
So people in Brazil, a lot of people still use the same combination
the
of a color mm-hmm. flag. I don't know what the means is. But, you know, the cat, like, let's say two colors in the beginning, you use a white, and then it's blue and white, right?
Blue and white.
And then yellow, blue, and white. And then you start, you go for green, blue, yellow, and white for set 11. And then you start to lose the color again. You, you lose green, blue, yellow. When you get in white, we call the go card. That's like, you know, the mastery, really mastery.
Okay.
And some style, you get different colors. You go kind of through karate. White, yellow, orange, blue,
right,
green, brown, and then red.
Now you have purple.
Purple,
then
purple. Then red. So the last one in this study is red.
So the colors signify
levels
of ability. And what do you call the black belt level in your martial art in Capoeira? Master or?
We call
it master.
Master.
And how long does it take to get from day one beginner to master level? How many years average?
Depends. You can be a master in 10 years. You can be a master 5 years. Because you have a lot of different school, like karate.
Yeah.
I know some people went to karate school in 2 years have black belt.
2 years?
Yeah.
So it's
his ability, actually.
Each individual's ability.
Yeah. If you want to take the test, like some students try to rush. I want to rush. You know, in 3 months, I want to take a test for orange belt. I want to take a test for blue belt. You know, we basically have the same problem in capoeira. And some people in Brazil, as like my master, we don't use any belt.
Oh, I see.
It's kind of tough to say, you know, if you be in the harder and you have a belt, let's say you have a red belt on, so you are master already. And you're going to see a lot of people in the harder that don't have any belt on.
And you don't know what they are.
You don't know. I mean, you never expect how strong he can be or how weak he can be. So that's what my master should say. You always hide your power. Be away from belt. Belt is made to hold your pants. That's all.
I see. And are there associations with Capoeira? Do you get a certificate?
Yeah, they have. Now it is.
Let's say
about 5 years ago.
Yeah, about that.
About 5 years ago.
A certificate, and you have to get then your master's degree, like your belt. You guys go through all the, from white to red, when you finish, you get your belt and the certificate.
As
like
karate.
A diploma.
I see.
Because the whole thing is capoeira. Capoeira, we still going through the, how I say, let's say a transform of age and accept capoeira as a martial art.
Right.
I believe the karate might be going through this before.
Right.
We just a little bit behind.
Yeah.
We just
not
little
everyone
behind.
Understands what it is
you
yet.
Know, exactly. We still a little bit behind of make people understand what capoeira means. As like go to school and study capoeira for real and get your rank, like karate. Mm-hmm. I believe when I say karate, I don't mean karate. I say kung fu, taekwondo, kickbox, whatever. You know, they might be going through these things about maybe 20, maybe 30 years ago.
Right.
You know, we still in Brazil, we got a few problems in Brazil. So
right.
We're still going through, you know, capoeira as a martial arts, capoeira as a sport or anything, you know,
right.
Something like that. So we're still going through, you know,
stage.
Stimulate and try to put together everything. Okay, if you want to be a red belt to get it, let's say go for through 4 years to be a master.
I see.
5 years to be a
master. So what you're trying to do is get a standardized grading system.
Right.
And all the development that karate went through years before.
Right, because
it's so young, and you guys are like founding fathers of spreading it, you know, and you have a big job ahead of you. But
I know.
Do you think its future's good as a martial art for everybody? Can anyone study it?
Anybody can study capoeira.
Yeah.
Anybody can do it as karate. If you're gonna take seriously as you take any different martial arts, you can do it.
Is it a good self-defense art?
Yeah. It is. And this is one thing too, I think is a good self-defense because for the reason that people still don't know what capoeira means. If you go on the floor and do a weak say hole, if you go on the floor and do a hole, people be fighting with you, they're gonna stop and say, what are you doing on the floor? Is it break this or something? You can come back from there in a kick and you never expect what it is.
Yeah. Now, what is the main reason for fighting low? Is it to, was it to avoid weapons or something, the slaves, or? Why the ground fighting so much in capoeira as opposed to karate?
right, they say that for the freedom in Brazil, for the revolution, when the slave make the revolution stuff, we fight for the freedom, and the, in Brazil, we don't fight against gun or anything.
I see.
We fight against soul.
Oh.
So, you know, like if somebody gonna try to hit in the face, you always do try to go lower and lower. And also, for the reason we fight against people, they use too much hands technique, actually.
Right.
We don't have that many blocks.
Right.
We always use our hand and ability to do something pretty between the kick.
Uh-huh.
It's like martial arts, that's what I know. Martial arts means a beautiful fight.
Right.
We try to really make a beautiful fight.
Uh-huh.
If somebody gonna kick you, we just don't wanna block and do something. We wanna kick you back and do something exciting.
Uh-huh.
So, you know, depending on the ability, everybody always try to, yeah, look what I did, you know, handstand. Hey, I can't do handstand in one hand. You know, so people always try to, every time when people try to, somebody try to kick you or punch you, we try to get away. No block, but use your hand to get away. Let's say do a cartwheel to the side.
Oh.
It's escape already.
So it's a personal test of your abilities.
Right.
As opposed to just a quick block punch. Your philosophy is to do it with finesse and make the attacker look foolish.
Right. Work in his ego. Try to fool him around.
You do the psychology trip,
psychology
huh?
Trip.
You confuse him, right?
Yeah, it's very confused. Can't
because, yeah, you know, I was watching you earlier, and when you go down, the first impression is, oh, he's weak.
Right.
But that's not it at all. Because
there was a way to hide something. Always hide something.
It's deceptive, right? So anyone can do it, huh?
I think so. I mean, I think anybody can look up with it. You guys can try to look up with it. Look for the right guys and go and take a classes and, you know, try to pump this up. Keep it.
It seems like the deceptive moves work really well against maybe two or three attackers. Do you think so?
Yeah. We have a lot of movement, like you can stay down and up at the same time and hit and go down. And somebody like punch you can go down and hit at the same time. So you have a lot of different stuff to defend and attack mm-hmm. at the same time.
And how do you compare it to other martial arts? Let's say karate or taekwondo or aikido.
I think capoeira have the same power.
Same power?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because We have very unique style, and I don't want to say we're better than anybody.
Right. Uh-huh.
Just I think we are in the same level.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's very.
Have you ever sparred friendly, let's say, against martial artists or anything like that?
Yeah, I have a lot of different sparring for a lot of different martial artists.
What usually happens?
The thing, we have a different style, like I say, so it's very hard to people hit us because you move too fast, you never stop. And all the martial arts, you always stay still. And you always moving, now you jinga, you go to the side and the uh-huh. other side and do negative and hole everything. Fast.
Yeah.
So it's very hard.
Is it easy for you to hit them?
Yeah, it's very easy, but I don't say it's impossible to get hit, so I can get hit for anybody anytime. But I say it's kind of hard to hit people who do capoeira because it moves so fast.
What techniques do you like the most out of your system?
Meia lua de compasso.
Now, what is that?
It's a low kick. It's a low kick. You put both hands on the ground and use the speed. We say a meia lua de compasso, 180 degrees.
Oh, it's like that.
It's
the
like
one you were doing with that whipping motion?
Go all the way lower.
Uh-huh.
And keep your body real lower and your legs going. You hit the heel part on your mm-hmm. foot. We can go for here, on the mm-hmm. side. So basic meia lua de compasso is like something really unique of capoeira. I haven't seen in another martial like this kick.
I see.
And people actually never gonna expect you gonna do that.
No.
Every time you go to the side or escape to, you know, lower level, people just like, you know, kick you, you're going down and you can get away from that. Every time you go down, you better wait for something up there.
Well,
the legs will be right on.
It seems like even if you don't make contact to the jaw, if you hit anywhere on the body, it's going to hurt because your kicks don't really snap.
Right.
The capoeira kicks, they drive through, right?
Right.
They, no pulling back, right?
Yeah.
So
no.
All your body weight is behind it?
We use the speed and body weight all the time.
Did you ever have to use it in a real fight? Self-defense?
Yeah. We still have, they still have in Brazil, called roda capoeira. It's a circle of capoeira, in a place called Mercado Modelo. They play capoeira every day, every single day. Then we have a lot of fight.
Is it real?
Yeah, for real.
So it's like a competition, sparring?
Competition. The competition capoeira in Brazil is not like competition sparring here, like karate tournament. Yeah. No, we have a competition every single day, anytime. Because the people in Mercado Modelo, in Mercado Modelo example, people go in Mercado Modelo and try to be better than anybody. Uh-huh. So we go in there, we can say, I'm the best capoeira. Somebody else come up, let's say, I say, in an example, I say, I'm the best here in the circle. He come up, he try to beat me up. Somebody come up, try to beat he up. And we just keep going.
It's
going.
Like a challenge. Every day have a challenge.
Every single
day. If you're the best today, someone next is going to come.
Want to take your
so
time.
So you got all these young kids coming
come
up. Every
yeah.
generation
come up,
wants
come
to
up and try to take from you.
But in the circle, is there a judge in the middle? Or
no.
The judge is yourself.
If well, you go there because you can handle the fight.
So how does the fight stop? If someone gets knocked out or someone quits?
Yeah. Or somebody go there and break down. It's really, really mean, believe me. It's like kind
have you
kind
been in
impossible.
Any of those?
Yeah, we've been there
yeah,
a few times.
Yeah, go there all the time.
Sometimes the police come and break out because, you know, we're talking about serious full
fights,
contact.
And like blood and everything, so you have to stop.
But it's still done with respect?
See, the whole thing in capoeira is still, as I say, you have to go through those things. We try to get a point and show respect. Winston in school, as let's say our class, when you want to take capoeira from us, we make a line and you put it, you know, your right hand on your heart and open and you say salve. Salve means a lot of things, but salve and capoeira means we say, you know, we're going to show respect for the mastery all the time. No matter how good or how big you're going to be, you know, how big you are, but you're always going to show respect for that one, the teacher. Because in capoeira, it's really tough to get respect of someone.
No.
We always try to be better than anybody. We always, you know, people always try to do something new. If you come up and knock me up with a bensam, I'm going to see, well, I can do this with him. I can, you know, I'm going to kick you back in armada or something. I mean, a different name of kick. So basically, it's like, it's kind of tough to describe. Mm-hmm. When you have to stop, when you have to give up. Because the give up means we can break down a fight. Let's say if somebody started getting a real fight in the circle, in the harder, and you want to stop, you can stop. You stop and go back to the harder, but he's going to come back and catch you pretty soon. Oh, I mean, all the time.
Oh, he come back.
He come back to you. I
maybe
mean,
we wait
oh,
for
yes.
1 year.
They maybe
month,
waiting for you.
Next day.
Now,
he's going to get you back.
If you go walk in the circle, who knows who to fight? You walk in a circle and then you point. Oh, I want you. Come here.
No,
it's no.
They just get up together.
Get up together and do it. Nobody know who's gonna fight who.
Do you go by weight and size? You
no,
look
no,
at,
no, no weight, no size.
No weight,
you can fight
no weight, no size. You can fight anybody. You have to prove yourself like his ability and strong. You gotta be really strong and have quick. That's why capoeira be so quick.
Yeah,
you have to be quick and strong.
But let me ask you, are there tournaments in capoeira where there are judges and, you know, points are scored? How are they done?
There are capoeira tournaments back in Brazil, like a karate tournament in here.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, they're going through age and weight.
And is it equipment, full contact, or no contact?
No,
no contact.
Touch,
no protection. No, no. Full contact. We don't use any pad in the hands or on the legs or on the feet or anything.
With the judge.
Yeah,
yeah
you
gotta go for it. Judge and everything, but you gotta go for it.
You no can go full contact to the head?
Full contact. You can
yeah,
go
but
for it. That's the whole thing.
Kick anybody and bleed. Nobody can bleed if you kick. If you kick somebody, he start bleed, you have to stop the fight.
You know,
he lose the fight.
I see.
Once you can kick him, he, if you're out of bleed, you can go keep going on and on.
What about other divisions? Do they do forms or kata in capoeira? Is that training too?
Yeah, the forms, like the acrobatic stuff you did yesterday,
mm-hmm.
That's our form, you know, you do like a sequence, like jinga, negativa, together,
right.
Then have open. That's when you come, do a lot of flips and kicks.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, show your technical ability.
I'll tell you, I've seen many, many martial arts, and capoeira impresses me the most as far as body conditioning goes. I mean, you guys are in great shape. You don't lift weights, and it's all from that constantly going down and doing handstands, and more or less a gymnastics type strength, isn't it?
It is.
It definitely would get anyone in great shape, and you know, you're never going to be overweight doing it, right? If you're training properly.
If you really train, at least 3 days a week.
Now, if someone came into your school, and you do have a school in L.A. now, right?
We actually don't have our own school yet, but we teach class around.
We're working in different studios. Different studios, teaching and seminars and stuff like that. But if a beginner came to you, what's the progression of technique? What would you first teach them in their training?
First, you need to put their student in shape.
Uh-huh. Conditioning.
Conditioning, you know. Working, like, stretching and body conditioning. Then you start basic movement, like Jenga. And Benson, that's the basic movement you have calculated. That's what you teach for students who start.
And then what's the next step after you get them in shape? What do you start teaching
them? The first step of capoeira is Jenga. Jenga is like the step you do, you move around.
It's your footwork.
Yeah, you have to do Jenga. If you cannot Jenga, you cannot be a capoeira.
Mm.
You have to Jenga. Jenga is the basic step of capoeira because as we don't have too much blocks and stuff. If you keep doing Jenga, you can get away from the kicks of anybody that's trying to hit you.
So do all the techniques come out of Jenga movement?
Jenga. Every kick you have to come from Jenga. Mm-hmm. Every time we do Jenga, we try to, you know, blind the guys. You actually never know. You're going to be stepping back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, kick, back and forth, back, kick. Mm-hmm. So basically, if you do Jenga and you try, if you try to catch a person in Jenga, we're going to be doing this, Jenga, Jenga, Jenga. He never know really when you're going to kick.
Right.
If he try to, okay, he's going to kick from here. No, we kick from here, here. Yeah. Step side, both feet back, side, side. You know, move around the body. So basically, the very beginning of capoeira is Jenga, Negativa, Cucurinha, Esquiva, Role. You know, so a lot of low technique. I'm on the ground, try to, you know, block and...
You know, your kicks are really unique. Some of them do resemble karate kicks, but not most of them. How were they developed? Were your kicks influenced by other systems, or are they just developed from Africa? And why are they done the way they do?
I think it's because of the way how to... for the reason we have to survive.
Yeah.
And for the reason we have to hide the art, and we don't have really any like straight kicks as karate or any other martial art, we try to hide the kick all the time. As you can see, sometimes in capoeira, we go real slow and then take speed from there.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, always just try to fake the person.
Uh-huh.
And I think for the reason we try to put a flips between the fight. You know,
to disguise the kicks. I see.
So that's why we have like a lot of different kicks.
Uh-huh.
You have to kick from anywhere.
Right.
Anywhere. If you have your head on the floor, you have to kick. You have to kick. You know. So that's why we have so many different kicks of you know, all the martial arts. But we do have like a lot of basic kicks that people have in karate.
Uh-huh.
We just have a different name.
Yeah.
But it is front kick, side kick, back kick, roundhouse kick.
Uh-huh.
We have all this in capoeira too. You know, but it's different name. It's like Taekwondo get a different name of karate.
But the presentation is quite different.
Right.
But you said earlier, not too many blocks or punching. Why is that?
Because the slave, when they make their form, they cannot use the hand because they tie the hand.
Oh, sometimes they have their hands tied too. Yeah,
I see. So all they had to fight with was their feet.
The feet,
right.
Oh, that makes sense.
Yeah, some people got to do that.
Now, you're pretty innovative. You took capoeira and then you added to it to create a free form for the internationals in Long Beach, California for 1989, and you won the championship, didn't you? In the soft style?
I did the one in Long Beach tournament. I'll be winning a lot of tournaments in here in New York City. Mm-hmm. And Washington, and here in L.A. Basically, I don't remember the names and dates where I win. I win a few tournaments.
Uh-huh.
And I did try Long Beach, too. But what I did in Long Beach, I mean, whatever I did in tournaments and forms, I made up my own.
Yeah.
Because basically, we really don't have any forms as karate, number one, two, or three, and go too long.
Right.
You know? We call sequence. Uh-huh. It's like about 30 seconds.
Right.
It's real quick, like basic kicks and mm-hmm. blocks and escape. Mm-hmm. But I made it my own. I put a lot of flip on them. And kicks and combination jing, and I try to show the people. I'm still shaking when I get in front of the judge. I'm like kind of shaking because the people don't know what it is. They really don't give the credit they should give to me.
Yeah.
You know.
But you won first place
I
at the Long
first
Beach.
A lot of,
that's a great accomplishment because people from all over the world come to that tournament, at Parker's tournament. So it does show what capoeira is capable
of.
Yeah,
a lot of people get no capoeira by this. I'm glad. I feel proud of myself to do that.
Now, is it very popular in Brazil? Are there capoeira schools all over?
Or? All over. It's very popular in Brazil, like China, karate in China.
Uh-huh.
Oh, and Japan.
Yeah.
You know, this school all over the country, so.
Now, what about outside Brazil? There's only really you two guys in America right now going around and showing people what it really is. But are there any schools in Europe? Or?
Yeah, there's a lot of different schools all over Europe.
Uh-huh.
In Italy, Germany, Spain, all over. Capoeira is really growing now.
It's growing fast,
yeah,
huh?
Growing pretty fast.
Are they Brazilian instructors? Are they qualified Brazilian instructors?
Yeah, a lot of Brazilian.
Most all of the Brazilian.
A lot of places.
And how do you see the future of it? Do you see it growing?
I think capoeira is going to do well soon. It still is kind of weak now,
uh-huh.
but I think soon it's going to be better.
We're going to get there.
What are the benefits of studying capoeira on a regular basis, physically and mentally? What does it do for you?
Keep your body in shape.
Yeah.
And if you know how to use it, it can be a dangerous weapon as a self-defense.
Mm-hmm. And is it used in Brazil by the military or the police's self-defense training?
Yeah.
They use it right now. Yeah, they do. About, let's say, 10 years ago,
uh-huh.
they started using.
Do they have a special system just for the quick technique, self-defense technique?
Yeah. Like, they use the most dangerous part of capoeira
mm-hmm.
to teach just for the cops and...
The most dangerous
security,
part, huh?
Yeah, just the most dangerous part in capoeira.
Now, are there any great masters in capoeira, like, let's say, in karate, there's Masayama or mm-hmm. Mr. Funakoshi? Are there any?
A lot. Let's say, still alive, or I can't say one's passed away.
Yeah, right? Some people pass away.
Bimba, Pastinha, alive have Besouro, Cordão de Ouro.
What makes these masters so great?
Bimba, Mestre Bimba, his real name is Manuel do Reis Machado.
Mm-hmm.
He brought back capoeira, and he was the one to be, let's say, a big hero in capoeira. He got a big name because he took capoeira back to the streets and to school. Because in 1890, capoeira wasn't, you know, stopped. If they have a law in Brazil, if any cops catch anybody in the street doing capoeira, we're going to jail.
1890,
said this? Anybody in Brazil, if you catch you practice doing capoeira. Ginga in the street, you're going to jail.
Is that right?
Yeah, because people started using capoeira as a...
To steal
people and kill people.
Oh.
So the government stopped. And Bimba, Mr. Bimba, he was the one to... Somehow he gets some powerful in the meantime stuff to get back to school. He was the first master open school in Bahia, Brazil.
Oh.
And then Pastinha is another guy too that he gave a big name of capoeira.
So these masters brought respect to the
respect
art, like karate is today
karate,
for men, women, and children.
And many more. I just don't remember basic names right now, but mm-hmm. There was a lot of people.
There's a lot of people, a lot of famous people doing capoeira.
We have a lot. We have like people still alive, as Camisa. He was a Bimba student, right?
Yeah.
Camisa.
Acordeon.
Suassuna in São Paulo. You know, there's a lot of people. I have they have a good fights also. We call back in Brazil in Bahia. There's a guy. His nickname was King Kong. Mm-hmm. He is like. he give Cat bad reputation to Capoeira too, because he is a fighter.
Yeah, he's a fighter.
He's a fighter. And another guy is Jim, you know. I think he's a great fighter, Capoeira. He's like, he's a ginger.
he's big, yeah.
He is, I mean.
Tell me, does Capoeira have any philosophy to it, to head hereby?
We say, as in karate, when people walk in school, we say, yes, down, or some people, somehow show respect.
Right.
We have, in Capoeira, we say salve. We put it out first.
Oh, like you were saying.
Yeah, on the test, and you say salve. This means to show respect to the mastery, or whoever teach a class to you, you're always going to show respect. And, you know, he's going to be in there in whatever you are.
Yeah.
You know, so you can respect as a student, even you can, because you see Capoeira, hey, it's like karate, you get old and people be growing and they might be better than you in like 2 or 3 years and try to go and take your place in there.
Yeah.
So, you know.
But I mean, the philosophy is only to use it as if you have to, as self-defense, right?
Right. Yeah. And shake hands too, when you start Capoeira.
Yeah. Tell me about how you do your salutation. Show me. What does that mean?
You shake your hands. Show respect to the person means you shake your hands.
Shake your hands.
But watching the eyes, don't you ever? Don't you see in Capoeira? Don't go for smiling.
I see.
You see, a smile of a Capoeira can cut as a knife.
Ah.
So never go for the smile. Sometimes when you go down on the harder, we show respect to the beating ball.
Right.
Basically,
uh-huh.
You go to the master, whoever play the beating ball.
Right.
Show respect to the beating ball and. Touching the ground, cross yourself,
uh-huh.
Shake hands, and watch.
Wow.
By the time you be down with the beating ball, the fight started.
Uh-huh.
And you
if you're going down with
right
the beating ball, some people take you down right there. You even don't go to the single fight no more.
Uh-huh.
Pum, go anyways. I mean, take your head and bang your knees. The fight is over.
Yeah.
So basically, when you go down the beating ball, watch out.
The fight starts right there.
Yeah.
When you go down the beating
ball. Now, there's no bowing, right?
No, the ball is this. You shake hands.
Yeah.
Cross yourself,
right,
and then go basically
and flip.
Flip. Basically, you go into the circle and flip. Or we call awu, or Carl Hills.
Uh huh.
You know, or go up in a whole leg, depending on what kind of game you're gonna do it. Basically.
Mm-hmm. Now you never start technique or matches standing up and shaking hands, right? It's always down.
Always low.
Always low.
Always can if somebody's playing there, but if you wanna cut the game,
right?
If you see somebody else playing, spine and how they can go there and take one out.
Mm-hmm. Take one out and start sparring the other one.
Mm-hmm.
So you give it back to this one. Whoever give it back, you're going to fight that one.
Yeah.
Once again, watch out for him.
Now,
because he might don't want you to cut the fight because he might, you know, he want to hit the person he fight with and he might be mad if
in some martial arts systems, they say when you bow, never look down at the floor. Look at the other man's feet.
Right.
Because if his feet aren't there, he's probably jumping on your head.
Right.
So the same thing, right?
Right.
But in Capoeira, in the street, where they fight for real in Brazil, do they actually do this, shake hands, the formal, or they just start?
No. Just go down and shake hands, and depending how bad you want the guy, you can knock somebody down right on the beating ball.
Yeah.
And that's illegal.
It's illegal.
Because you took your eyes off him.
It's legal. I mean, you should.
Why in street fight, you're not going to expect, like, if you do karate, if you have a fight in the street, you're not going to do, okay, I'm going to do that.
Yeah,
right. It's fine.
You're going to
fight.
Yeah.
So forget about forms and.
Forget about pretty kicks.
Just get away.
Now, if you were attacked in a street self defense situation, would you still do Capoeira, go down the same thing?
Same thing
on the street, right? There.
Uh-huh. No problem.
I say kick first and then go for jinga or go for hole. I mean lower kicks.
Mm-hmm.
Depending who you fight too. If you know you're gonna fight somebody in karate, karate means somebody that know how fight.
Right.
I definitely use Capoeira because I can fake hand. A lot of people still don't know what Capoeira means. But if I'm gonna fight somebody in the street that never know how fight, they just wanna get in a fight, street fight. I kick first and then I go do something lower just to, you know, make you stop and like, what is this?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I definitely use Capoeira.
Now, you gentlemen are aspiring actors and martial artists, and Nielsen's already got some film roles going. And do you think Capoeira is ready for martial arts movies? If it was on the big screen, what would that do?
A lot of money. yeah, I think if people show capoeira on the screen, I think everybody, no one in America, but still in Brazil and a lot of places, is prepared to see something different. I think people can a little bit, you know, tired of semi-regular karate.
Uh-huh.
I think capoeira do good, really good in the screen as a martial art, as a dance. Like,
yeah.
We have a music and a history of capoeira. And I think capoeira do pretty good in the screen.
I think the tumbling would be dynamic, you know, when
right.
you flip and kick somebody. Yeah. You know, usually they fake that in the movies and Hong Kong type movies. They use a trampoline in it, but you got to see these guys flip. This is the real thing. I mean, you actually flip over a car?
Yeah, I can do that.
And land on your feet?
Right. No trampoline, no nothing.
Wow.
Just because we try to show people capoeira. We have a goal in America, right? We have a goal in here. We try to show people what capoeira means. So we use every weapon as possible to show the power of capoeira.
Mm-hmm.
So basically we're going after the maximum to train. We be training a lot.
Yeah.
We be training really, really hard to be in here talking to you and try to do, you know, all this video and show people what capoeira means. So we be training. We always try to do something new. We always try to train and create something. So, you know, we're going through not only capoeira, basically, but I can do a flip in here, capoeira flip, but I can do a double this way, so let's do a double.
Uh-huh.
You know, and as you can see, we're going to school right now, acting class, English class, we try to be in a screen show. Because I think a screen, movies is the best way and the quick way to people see capoeira.
Right.
As Bruce Lee did in Kung Fu, Korean box, right?
Yeah.
I mean, he's a Thai box, whatever he did it.
Right.
Wasn't
Chinese box.
Chinese box, Chinese. Right. Uh-huh. Chinese box. That was the best way people knew. I'm a big fan of Bruce Lee. I used to be in the meeting, try to have my body as he used to have in all those things. He was a great fight.
And what's going to happen if capoeira becomes very, very popular and there's not enough instructors? Everybody wants to study it.
No,
well, at least we have the videos, right?
Right. Yeah. Videos, buy the videos and you can train.
Gonna learn.
And learn. But there are a lot of instruction.
How do you feel about the American as students as compared to the Brazilian student?
I think they can be good, but take longer to learn because
yeah.
it's something new here. They never saw. So in Brazil, if you go to Brazil, learn fast because everybody do capoeira.
Little kids in the street, everybody,
yeah.
right?
So here it's kind of difficult to America to understand capoeira, so it takes long to learn.
Mm-hmm. Well, capoeira has great representatives here, and I think
yeah.
it's going to be very big, and I wish you the best of your success.
Thanks.
Thank you very much for coming today.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Thank you.